There's this article about Pawlenty that he made a U-turn on his ideas on climate change. He's now, let's say, accentuating the fact that there need to be jobs and economic growth, and that the best solution in order to preserve economic growth would of course be nuclear power. Well, he's turned into a complete shill, in a complete whore of Washington and the banking system. Because, of course, nuclear power is not the only option. There are many other options. I made a video about MTEC technology, which would make solar thermal power very lucrative, but there are plenty of examples. And also, you know, for somebody that has been in action committees on climate change and has been even made promotion audio, radio addresses and stuff like that to ask for action on climate change, to suddenly turn around and say, you know, economical growth is more important, that is just so stark that in Holland or in a country, I cannot really imagine that somebody that is such a prostitute of the commercial interests would be allowed to be in government at all. He's just, you know, the flip-flop used to be something that you cannot do as a politician. Well. And then, of course, there are climate skeptics that will say I'm talking nonsense. But climate skeptics, just get your facts straight, get into the real information, learn a little bit about the future of Earth. You know, this week a prediction for Europe for Dutch temperatures would be 40 to 50 degrees at the end of this century, which is very unusual because we're not in a tropical country here. And that's the reality. That is what people think if they really think very hard and they check all the facts and they work on it for years, then that's what they find. It's not nonsense. And if you're like concerned about your job, stuff like that, about employment of people, then you should especially try to break the power of people like Pawlenty. Because it is the nuclear, let's say, nuclear power, building a nuclear power plant is not a highly intensive job. It's not a job for many people. It's a job for a few people. It's actually the only way to centralize, to keep centralized energy supply for the masses, which means that everybody will have to pay for their energy. While if you try to break the power of this lobby, of the group that is for nuclear energy, you'll find that there is plenty of different inventions and technologies that you can use to create energy in your home, that you can install almost yourself, and that can save you a hell of a lot of money in the future, and also of course protect your environment and reduce the emissions for climate change. And that will mean a lot of jobs, you know, all these clean jobs for installing solar water heaters and solar air heaters and I have no idea what else, but you can cook with heat, you can cool with solar heat very efficiently. All that stuff is available, but it's being pushed back by the industry at the moment, all wishing you would just go for clean coal, which is a big lie, and nuclear power, because then you'll be paying your monthly electricity bill just like you did before, and otherwise you'll be free of that burden. So that's the economical side of it. Clean energy means plenty of jobs and a cheaper life. But no, this Pawlenty, he's bought now, and you can listen to it. I'll link the article next to this video.